us. Because God loves us. Would you please open your prayer books, please, to page 305. Would someone very loudly please read that first question at the top of the page? When Jesus called together the 12 disciples, this is what he was asking of them. And like you and I, their answer was, I will with God's help. Because we can't do it without God's help. Next question, third question, top 3 or 5. So I'm going to read that.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
Excellent. Way back then, as now, this might prove to be the most challenging promise we make. We live in an increasingly adversarial world. We live in an increasingly polarized culture, and way too often this results in violence. Violence in word as well as in deed. This is, I think, the deepest wound from which we all suffer. And this wound distorts what's really real. That every person, in fact, everything in all creation has been created in the image and likeness of this magnificent loving God. You have been created in the image and likeness of God. You have been created in the image and likeness of God. You have been created in the image and likeness of God. And so have I. And so is my dog. And so have been the beautiful flowers and the squirrels and every species of every living thing on this planet. We have all been created in the loving image of God. But we forget that. And even in the moments when we remember that that applies to us, we tend to forget that it applies to everyone, especially when someone has been insulting to us or someone we love, when someone has done harm to someone, when someone has administered violence in either word or deed. They too have been created in the image and likeness of this loving God. But that image has gotten so clouded over with so much pain that it's distorted. But we're being asked by God, by Jesus, to look for that image. To look for that image in every single being. So healing for us probably necessitates that we all take time to stand down, to take a deep breath, take several deep breaths, reconnect with our own soul, where the image and likeness of this loving God resides, and remember, remember who we are and whose we are. Respond to others in every situation out of this deep, deep place with God's help. Respond rather than react. Because responding is to see the other as myself. And reacting is to pushing away or rejecting the other as unworthy. By a show of hands, how many of you are on Facebook? Yeah, me too. And this is my biggest challenge, is not to react. Respond rather. Responding always offers the possibility of deep healing. Remember that we are all in this together. What happens to one of us happens to all of us. Reacting, on the other hand, is alienating, deeply wounded, inflicting soul violence. Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being? This is what Jesus sent for the 12 to do and to be. This is what Jesus sends us for to do and to be. Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being? Let us pray. Sustain us, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give us inquiring and discerning hearts, the courage to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. And we pray, empower us for your service. Grant us the strength and perseverance to proclaim in word and deed your good news in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen.